Attention, attention. This is Rob from Rob's Movie Collection. A year for every a movie for every year of my life. 1970. MASH.
Fog I see, visions of the things to be, the pains that are withheld for me, I realize and I can see, that suicide is painless, it brings on many changes, and I can take or leave it, if I please.
Okay, folks, it's MASH from 1970. This is the original movie that inspired the long-running TV series. It's based on a novel by Richard Hooker. It was called MASH, a novel about three army doctors. It's directed by Robert Altman. And it starred Donald Sutherland, Elliot Gould, Tom Skerritt, Sally Kellerman, Robert Duvall, and many, many other actors. Many, many, many other actors, several of whom were making their film debut in this movie, and several who went on to star on the TV show, including Gary Berghoff as Radar. This film was a big hit. It was nominated for 5 Academy Awards, and it won for Best Screenplay for the writer Ring Lardner Jr., which is ironic because so much of it was ad-libbed and he wasn't too happy about that. I first knew MASH from, of course, the TV show, the very successful TV show starring Alan Alda. That was my first MASH. When I came to this, it was very different. This is a satirical black comedy, which the series was also sometimes. But when I first saw this, I saw this on a CED disc, which one of my subscribers, you know who you are, will appreciate that. When I saw it, it was just odd to me. I was used to my Hawkeye and my Trapper, and suddenly here were these other people playing them, and you had Donald Sutherland, and you know, it was different than what I knew, and I was a bit resistant to it. I was, you know, I was young, and I wasn't too thrilled about it at first, because to me it was fake. This wasn't MASH. This wasn't the MASH that I knew. But you know what? That's what I love about movies. Movies are immortal. They can wait. They're very patient, and they'll wait for you to catch up and to grow a little bit and experience life a little bit, and they'll still be there when you're ready to accept them, when you're ready to give them another try. And that's how it happened with MASH. You know, I got a little older, and I would see it. They used to show it on TV a lot more, and I would see clips of it, and I would start watching it, and eventually it grew on me to the point where now I can appreciate it as its own film. And really, to be fair, it's where the series came from. If it wasn't for this, there'd be no series. But I can enjoy both now. I can enjoy both characters, Alan Alda's version, Donald Sutherland's version, and everyone else, and really enjoy it. So MASH is a dichotomy of war and humor wrapped in a thinly veiled allegory for Vietnam. Yeah, that's right. I took a film class. Yeah. I'm not even sure I used the word allegory right in that sentence, but whatever, you know what I mean.
Good morning. Today's musical selections will be rendered by Achi Takamura's Hiroshima Bobcats.
It was about Vietnam. Everybody knew it was about Vietnam, more so back in those days. Even I knew after a while it was about Vietnam. So, they never, you know, they were addressing the things that were going on at the time, especially in 1970, which was still kind of in the thick of it. And it's interesting about this movie. Most of the time when I talk about these movies in these little videos, I try not to go into the plot too much because I don't want to ruin it for anybody who hasn't seen it, even though this is like a 45-year-old movie. But it's, you know, there's no real plot. I mean, there is, but there isn't. There's no linear plot in this movie. It's kind of almost a disjointed series of events ending with this weird football game, you know, and it's, they're all kind of connected by these goofy characters and tied together by these weird camp announcements.
Attention, attention. Colonel Blake has secured for us the halls of Montezuma. So big, only the biggest of the screen can bring it to you all. Technicolors, tell it to the Marines, those lovable lugs with wonderful mugs so we now love more than ever. Follow Lieutenant Punchy, Limey, Babyface, Doc, the Poet, Pretty Boy, and Slattery through some of the most interesting war films yet created.
Robert Altman, the director, encouraged the actors to ad-lib. That's the kind of director he was. They went off script a lot. And because of that, you have a lot of this technique of overlapping dialogue where people are speaking over each other. And it makes it more, some people say, more realistic or more, you know, chaotic. Or both worked for the setting, for the movie. It also happens in with scenes itself. Like, there's a scene where Hawkeye and Duke are in Henry's office talking to him, and they're trying to convince him that they need a new chest cutter who would eventually become Trapper John McIntyre. And as they're speaking about the necessity and why they need this new chest cutter, the scene cuts to the pre-surgery area of the hospital, and it shows them, those same characters, walking around as the dialogue from the previous office scene continues over that. So there's a lot of that sort of thing going on in the movie, overlapping with the scenes and the dialogue, so it makes it kind of chaotic and fast-paced at times.
Attention, attention. Why do I start editing these things so damn late at night? That is all.
The whole movie is, it's comedy followed by tragedy. I mean, you got some really silly scenes in it, and these characters, Hawkeye and Trapper John, are just given the finger to authority left and right, and these insane situations. And just when it gets to the point where it's just, you think it's just going to be all crazy, suddenly they cut back to surgery, and you have these bloody scenes where they're doing these things and you know, cutting off legs, and there's blood squirting, and it suddenly takes you back to reality again. And that's kind of how it goes, back and forth like that. If you haven't seen MASH, I definitely recommend it. It's very well worth the watch. Interesting to see the beginning of what influenced the TV series, and to see a lot of these actors that we know now and that have, in many ways in today's world, have kind of passed on in their careers, and how they started out, you know, and early on. And you know, these, Elliot Gould, Donald Sutherland, and all these guys, you know, they had these big careers throughout the 70s, and they were the top stars back then. For a lot of the younger viewers, you know, Donald Sutherland is not just the guy from Hunger Games, you know, he had a big career before that, and this is one of his first things that he did, and kind of shot him to fame here. So it's definitely worth watching, and it's very funny, and it's just, I highly recommend it. So that is my movie for every year of my life, for the year 1970. And I'm trying to keep these going, and hopefully we'll be able to keep going with these into 1971. So, all right. I will see you guys next time, and keep watching those movies. Bye.
Attention, attention. This run-in gag has gotten old. Thank God it's the end.